The next topic is encephalo. Encephala, nothing but brain. Yes. Brain. So what is that? The brain is, it is a one of the, so the brain is commonly known as a encephalon. The brain is commonly known as, the brain is scientifically called as a, and the technical terminology is called as a encephalon. So the average, the weight of the adult human weight of the brain is approximately 1200 to 1400 grams. Approximately how much? The 12 to 1400 grams of the weight. What is the brain? The scientifically, the technical terminology of the brain is called as a encephalon. Encephalon. Cephalon, nothing but cepha means head. Encephalon. So the brain is commonly called as a supercomputers of the organisms. This is commonly known as supercomputer. Supercomputer. Why we are calling it a supercomputer? It is conducting all coordination. Nothing but it is doing all. What is the coordination of the neural and chemical coordination is controlled by the brain. The neural control and chemical control is both are controlled by the brain. This is called as a supercomputer. The weight of the brain in adult, approximately 1200 grams to 1400 grams. 1200 to 14 grams. In females, I have a 1200 to 1250 grams in females. Okay, the males consistence of 1350 grams in males, consistent of 1350 grams. In rare cases, they have 1400. In the rare cases, they have 1400 grams. So these brain, the weight of the brain is heavier than female. The what is that? The brain of the weight is heavier than female in human, in males. Clear. So the brain is completely protected by cranium, and it is located in the, what is that, a cephalic cavity, or called as a cranial cavity. The brain is covered by, brain is protected or located in cranial cavity. So protected by the cranial cavity, it is there, is in located in the cranial cavity region, located in the cranial cavity region. Clear. So this is the information about the brain. So the brain consistent, the brain containing the what is that, the surface of the brain consistent of more number of the bulges and depressions are there. The brain containing the outer surface of the brain. Before we are discussing about the detailed information, first we are discussing the outer surface of the brain containing more number of the bulges and depressions. The bulges and depressions are there. More number of the bulges and depressions are there. So these bulges and depressions are called as a gyres and sulci. The bulges part is known as a gyri. The depression part is called as a sulcus. Called as a sulci. So the brain is completely covered by the three covering membranes. Brain is completely covered by how many membranes? Three covering membranes. So what are they? First one. Brain is completely covered by three covering membranes. Covering are protective membranes. First one, the brain containing three membranes are, the first one is, what is that? Pia mater, arkenoid matter. The third one is dura matter. Pia matter, arkenoid matter, and dura matter. So what is that? The pia mater is the innermost layer. It is covered by the brain. It is the innermost layer. It is covered by the brain. Here. So the arkenoid matter is a middle layer. dura mater is outermost layer. Let's see the diagrammatical way, diagrammatical view of this layers. Okay, clear. Protecting membranes. Yes. So the brain is covered by the outermost covering membrane is known as a dura mater. On surface of the dura mater, there is a cranium pot is there. The dura mater is completely covered by the cranium. So the below of the dura mater, it is consistent of the one of the layer, second layer. The second layer is known as arachnoid matter. Clear? Second layer is called arachnoid matter. The third layer, the innermost layer of the brain is known as a pia mater. The innermost layer of the brain is called as a pia mater. Let's labeling of each and every layer for easy to understood. First one is known as a skull or cranium. The red one indicates the skull or cranium. The second, the black one is indicates second, the black one is called as a dura mater. The middle one is known as a arachnoid matter. The innermost layer is indicates pia matter. So first of all, the innermost layer is known as a pia matter. The innermost layer is made up of fibrous connective tissue. The innermost layer, first one, the pia matter, discussing about the, what is the pia matter. It is innermost layer of the brain. Clear? Innermost layer of the brain. Next one. The pia matter is made up of fibrous connective tissue sheath. Fibrous connective tissue sheath. So the fibrous connective tissue sheath. So the innermost layer is a very delicate and it is a vascularized sheath. The innermost layer, very delicate and it is a vascularized membrane. What is the meaning of the vascular? Vascular, nothing but the high blood flowing is occurs. That is known as vascular, nothing but blood flow. Vascular is nothing but blood flow. The high vascular was occur, nothing but this indicate very vascular membrane. Nothing but these are very huge amount of the blood is flows on pia mater region. Clear? What is the pia mater? It is the innermost layer of the brain. Clear? It is made up of fibrous connective tissue sheath. Clear? The third one is the innermost layer. It is very delicate and very sensitive. It is a vascularized membrane or vascular membrane. Nothing but it is high vascular. It is continuous flowing of the blood. So that is called as a vascular. Clear? So the second one is known as a arachnoid matter. Second one is called as a arachnoid matter. Listen carefully. What is the arachnoid matter? Arachnoid matter, nothing but it is a second layer of the brain, clear. And archini nothing but it is a internally connecting, nothing but it is a network of the membrane. It is a membrane, it is look like a fibrous net, nothing but it is a net like structure. This is known as a network, net like structure. It is a second layer of the brain. Are you clear? The second layer of the brain. First point, note down everyone. What is that? This layer, archinoid, nothing but the, you can imagine archinoid, nothing but the archinoids are spiders. Okay, the archinoids are under comes into what is archinoidia, spiders. So what is the meaning of it? Is a network like membrane. The archinoid, nothing but it is a network like membrane. It is a network like nothing but it is a one of the network like membrane, like this. This is known as a network like membrane. Okay, clear. So this membrane, this archinoid matter, it is made up of, it is made up of the collagen fibers. It is made up of collagen fibers. Collagen fibers. And very, very important. So there is a, first one is PR matter. Second one is a archinoid matter. There is a PR matter and archinoid matter had be one of the in between of the PR matter and archinoid matter have a one of the space, one of the cavity is appear. There is a, in between of the PR matter and archinoid matter, there is a cavity is there. That cavity is called as a, that cavity is called as a archinoid, that is called, what is that? Archinoidal space, or commonly known as a archinoidal space. So the space is completely filled with, the space is completely filled with the spinal fluid. The space is filled with one of the fluid. The detailed information about the membranes. Are you clear? So this is completely made of, so completely these are filled with one of the fluid. That fluid is known as a cerebral fluid. The fluid is called cerebral. Cerebral, nothing but brain. Cerebral fluid or spinal fluid. Spinal fluid. The two are similar. The cerebral fluid or spinal fluid. The two are there. Cerebral fluid or spinal fluid is there. So that is known as the, that is called as a PR archinoid space. The space is called Priya, what is a PIA archinoid space or archinoidal space? PIA archinoid or archinoidal space? Or subarchinoidal space or sub PIA, sorry, subarchinoidal space. Second one is known as a archinoidal matter. Third one, what are they? Third one is a dura matter. What is that? Dura matter. Dura matter. What is the dura matter? Dura matter, nothing but the outermost layer of the book. Outermost layer of the what is that? Brain. Outermost layer of the brain. Nothing but it is the third layer of the brain. Third layer of the brain. Complete detailed information. It is useful for the up to neat level. You can check your textbook. This is not there in textbook. This is not in detailed in textbook. It is a detailed information. Listen carefully. The third layer of the what is the brain, it is very hard, it is a very hard layer. It is made up of, it is made up of, it is also made up of collagen fiber. It is also made up of collagen fiber. It is a very hard layer, very hard layer, made up of collagen fibers. It is avascular membrane. It is one of the membrane. It is made up. It is known. This membrane is called avascular membrane. Nothing but there is no continuous blood flow. There is no blood flow was occurs. So that is called as a avascular membrane. Avascular membrane. So there is a in between of the second arcanoid matter and third dura mater have one of the space. The space is called as a subarcanoidal space. Sorry, subdural space. This is called as a subdural space. This is called subarcanoid space. This is called subdural space. So this space also filled with the spinal fluid. Are you clear? So third one is what is the third layer is called as a third layer of the brain. It is a very hard layer or hard membrane. It is made up of the collagen fibers. It is what is the avascular? Avascular, but there is no continuous flowing of the blood. Clear? Yes. Next, we will talk discussing about what is that? What is the importance of this cerebral fluid or spinal fluid? What is the importance? These are useful for these fluids are useful for to prevent of what is that mechanical shocks? Prevents of mechanical shocks in brain region. Clear? What is the importance? The prevents of mechanical shocks. Prevents of mechanical shocks and these fluids are useful for the transporting of information through the all over the brain. Transporting information, transporting impulse. Impulse all over the brain. So this is the information about the protective membranes. What are the first one? There is a three membranes are there. Pia mater, dura mater, well, arcanoid mater and dura mater is there. Pia mater is the innermost layer of the brain. It is a made up of fibrous connective tissue. It is the innermost layer and very delicate and vascular membrane. Second one is it is the second layer of the brain. It is a network like structure, nothing but it is you can imagine the net of spiders like that. So this is called as arcanoid matter. So it is a network like membrane. It is made up of the collagen fibers. It is also second hardest layer. It is a first hardest layer. It is a very smooth layer. First one is it is a third one is a in, third layer of the brain is known as a dura matter. It is a very hard layer. And this is containing collagen fibers. It is avascular membrane. So there is a gap in between of these two. First one is arcanoid, pia mater and arcanoid mater. That is space is called as a subarcanoid space. The space in between of pia mater and arcanoid. That space is called as a arcanoidal space. The arcanoidal space is filled with fluid is called as a spinal fluid or cerebral fluid. Next one, the second layer and third layer is called second layer is known as arcanoid mater. Third layer is known as a dura matter. The gap in between of these two layers is called as a subdural space. Subdural space. The dural space also filled with the spinal fluid. What is the important? The prevents of mechanical shocks and the transporting of impulse and all over the brain. Next, we will move forward. What is the gyrus and what is the sulcus? Very important. What is the gyrus and what is the sulcus? The complete detailed information about the brain. Listen carefully. What is that? Gyrus and sulci or sulci. What is the gyri and sulci? The outer surface of the brain, have more number of the bulges and depression. Very small depressions and very small bulges on surface of the brain. Like this, this is a brain. So this brain, the brain containing a small bulges like this, small bulges and small depressions are there. So small bulges, the bulge part is commonly known as gyri. The bulge part is commonly known as a gyres. So the depression part is, the depression part is called as a sulci. So what is the gyri? The on surface of the brain there is have a small, what is the bulge part and small depressions are known as a gyri and sulci. So what is the importance? So these are essential for, these are essential for spreading what is that neuron occupying area, neuron occupying area. So in our brain containing 100 billions of neuron, how many 100 billion, the human brain containing how many 100 billions of neurons are present. So what is that important? These are useful for the what is the increasing of spreading area of the neuron, increasing the spreading area of the neuron. Which one? The gyris and sulci are useful for the increasing the spreading area of the neurons in surface of the brain. So that is called gyri and sulci. So this is the gyri and sulci. Next one, the gyri and sulci. The sulci is a small depression. If the the sulci is leads into a long depression of the brain, the long depression of the brain, that is called as a fissure. If the normal depression, the normal depression of the surface of the brain is called as a sulci. Sulci. If the sulci is leads into a long depression of the brain, that brain is called as a, the depression is called as a fissure. The depression is called fissure. So this fissure is known as a cerebral, what is a papille? This fissure is called cerebral papille. What is the cerebral papille? What is the cerebral fissure? If the in surface of the brain there is a normal bulges and normal depressions are there. If the depression is, it's leads into inner side of the, it's a long, what is that, a large, what is that fissure, large, what is the depression was there, occurs in the brain region. So that is called as a fissure. So the fissure is commonly known as a cerebral papille. Cerebral papille. Let's see that. So this is known as a pia mater. So dura, so arachnoid matter. So arachnoid matter. This is known as a pia mater. This is known as arachnoid matter. The third layer is a dura matter. The more number of the papillae like structures, more number of the papillae or villi like structure, that is called as a cerebral villi or papillae. So this is the information about the membranes, protective membranes. So next we will forward. What is the next topic is, what is the structure of the brain? Structure of the brain.